morning, dear students. Today, we will do chapter 7, Animals Around Us. In my earlier video, I have told you about the different feeding habits and breathing organs in animals. Today, I will tell you the different types of movement shown by the animals. Students, in this chapter, now we will learn how and why do animals move. Students, we all know that animals move in search of food, water, shelter, and to protect themselves from their enemies. Students, different types of animals show different types of movements. Some animals fly in air, some animals move on land, some animals do swimming, and some crawl on the ground. So, first of all, we will discuss the movement of domestic animals. Students, domestic animals are the animals that live in our houses or near our houses. We can keep them as pet in our houses. Students, these have four limbs. The first limb which are at the front, they are called forelimbs. And the limbs which are at the back, they are called hind limbs. Students, with the help of these limbs, they can walk and they can run. Examples, cows, buffaloes, hen, goat, sheep, camel, etc. Now, it discuss about the movement in wild animals. Animals that live in forest and that are very dangerous to us, due to which we can't keep them as pet in our houses. They are called wild animals. Also, they have four limbs. With the help of their limbs, they can move, they can walk, they can run. Their limbs have soft padded feet, due to which they can move softly and silently, and they attack their prey. Examples, example, tiger, lion, elephant, bear, kangaroos, giraffe, etc. Now, we will discuss about movement in aquatic animals. Students, aquatic animals have special organ for movement, and they have fins. Fins are present in fishes. Fish have fins. It has a pair of fins which help in movement and balancing. Two paired fins help the fish to swim and move forward. The unpaired fin that is present in it helps in balancing, helps to keep the balance of the body. And the tail fin which is present at the back of the fish helps to change the direction while swimming. Now we will discuss about swimming in frog in water. Student, frog is an amphibian. It can live both on land and in water. When it is in water, it can swim with the help of its limbs. Student, its front limbs are quite short, which help it to land safely and with the help of it. And the hind limbs are quite long, due to which it can leap on the ground. Its limb also help to swim in water also. Now we discuss about the role of flippers in the turtles. Turtle also swim in water. It has paddle shaped limbs called flippers, which help to push back water, and due to which it moves front, and in this way it helps the turtle to swim in water. Now I will discuss about the limbs in the penguins. Penguins have also two pairs of limbs. The hind limbs, they are quite short, which due to which it can walk on the snow, on the ground. And its forelimbs are called flippers. Due to these flippers, it can swim in water. Next, we come to camel. Camel has long legs and padded feet. Due to its padded feet, it can walk and it can even run in the sand in the desert. That's why it is called sheep of desert. Camel has a hump on the back in which it stores fat and also water in the stomach. That's why a camel can live without food and water for several months. Now comes to birds. Birds are aerial animals which can fly in air. And for flying, its limbs are modified into forelimbs are modified into wings, and its hind limbs are quite short, due to which it can move on the ground. And when it is in air, it uses its wings to fly. students, some birds are flightless birds like emu, kiwi, ostrich and penguins. They cannot fly. Students, why they cannot fly? Because their body is quite bulky, heavy in weight, and also its wings are not quite strong, due to which it can't fly. They cannot fly or they can't fly high. So they are called flightless bird. Here you can see the pick of emu. Student, there are some insects which can also fly in air, like housefly, mosquitoes, butterflies, etc. Here you can see housefly. You can see its body is quite small and it has light wings, due to which it can fly. Here you can see butterfly. Butterfly has quite beautiful wings and its body is quite light, due to which it can fly. Now comes to the reptiles. Here you can see the turtles, lizard, crocodile and alligator. These are the reptiles which can crawl on the ground. These have four short limbs, due to which they can move on the ground. Animals like earthworm, they do not have limbs. Then how they move? They move with the help of their strong muscles. Their body is segmented into different segments and they have scales on their body, due to which they can crawl on the ground. Here you can see the snakes. How do snakes move on the ground? Snakes have scales. You can see the beautiful scales on the body of snakes that are quite rough, that makes its body rough, and due to which it can move easily on the rough surfaces or uneven surfaces. It can even run very fast. Also, its muscles are quite strong, due to which its body can be molded in any shape, can be stretched easily. Now we come, if we talk about water boatman, it is an insect which can swim in water. While swimming, it uses its legs as oars, and due to which it can move very easily. Students, there are also some insects like locust, grasshoppers, which can also use its hind limbs to hop. The human beings also have strong or well-developed limbs. We have two hind limbs, due to which we can stand, we can walk, we can run. And our four limbs, we can use them, which are called hands. We can use them for holding the different things. And we can do a lot of activities with our hands, like writing, like grasping, like holding the things, etc. Now we come to our next topic, animal migration. What is animal migration? Students, some animal migrate from one region to another region, or rather we can say from one place to another place, due to lack of food, due to lack of breeding places, and due to severe climatic changes in their habitat. Sometimes their habitat become very cold, due to which to escape from that extreme chillness, they move to the other place for few days or few months. And after some time, when the weather conditions become normal, they come back to their habitat. So this type of migration is shown by the birds, it's shown by the water animals, it's shown by the wild animals. So different types of animals shows the animal migration. In some cases, they migrate to search the food. Sometimes in their habitat, the food becomes scarce, and due to scarcity of food, they move to the other places. Here we are seeing that on the land, animals are migrating. In air, you can see this Arctic tern, Siberian crane, they move to other places. And in the sea, the blue whale or the humpback whale also, they migrate. So first of all, we will discuss about the movement by the aerial animal, the birds, Arctic tern. Student, do you know Arctic tern is a champion? It's a migrate champion, because every year it covers 35,000 kilometers from Arctic region in winter to Antarctic region, where the summer is occur at that time. This bird fly across the deserts and oceans. Also before their journey, they eat well and they reach to their destination. Then we discuss about caribou migration. Caribou in North America travels southwards to escape from extreme winter. During spring season, they start their journey northwards and they reach to North America. Next, we discuss the migration shown by the humpback whales in water. These humpback whales migrate from icy water of Antarctica to the warm places. This is the Siberian crane that every year comes to India during winter season and it returns to Siberia during summer. So every year these migratory birds, migratory animals and marine animals, they show migration. Now we come to our next topic of endangered animals. Students, who are endangered animals? The animals whose population has got considerably reduced and who are in getting of danger of extinct. The animals who have danger of getting extinct are called endangered animals. We have different species of endangered animals which are going to extinct. In this category, first we discuss about blue whale. This is the blue whale who is in getting endangered. This is giant panda who is also facing the of getting extinct. This is polar bear in polar region and this is African elephant in the Africa. All these animals are going to extinct. So it's our duty, we must try to save these endangered animals so that they can survive, they remain on the earth and we can live with them. So students, with this I end up my video. Thanks for watching the video.